I saw this post on Instagram, cracked me up, okay? Number one, I think it says something about men who have a mustache and no beard. They said that men who have mustaches and no beard are obviously bisexual or homosexual. And I was like, how do you determine a person's sexuality by how they wear their hair? That's including face hair. Not everybody is a walking cliche. Also, this list included gym rats with roid rage, pot smokers, and male YouTubers. I mean, male YouTubers is kind of accurate, but some of the other stuff that they was naming, like single fathers of young children, cracked me up a little bit. And I found it a little ironic. I saw this post on Instagram, but I was simultaneously having this conversation with some people on TikTok about what a single father actually is.
Men know more than women do.
They know
it's
more.
Not a lot of single fathers out here complaining. It's way more single mothers. So who make better decisions?
Nah. But come here's on. The thing.
Okay, huh?
That's not the same.
Who putting themselves in harm's way?
As far
women,
as what?
Just not, no discernment. Women say they have intuition, okay. but it don't help them pick a good man.
It's not because it's.
Why is there a single mother pandemic? If women,
it's a whole different.
Women making men bad decisions. Stick around. Nah.
As far as my opinion goes on what this gentleman is saying, women definitely have discernment and intuition. However, women are more likely to give men the benefit of the doubt. And there are more single mothers than single fathers, not because we purposely put ourselves in harm's way. It's because men are more likely to abandon women with children. Men have low tolerance and little resilience. They are more likely to leave or run instead of adapting to the tough times. Single fathers aren't complaining because they are avoiding a situation or don't even acknowledge that they have children altogether. It is very rare for a black man to be a solo custodial parent to their own child. Usually black men leave their children with their children's mother.
Now, when I try to tell men that there's a difference between a low energy baby mama and a high-end single mother, men will fight me to the death about there not being a difference and that men should just never date single mothers, right? So here it was, a whole bunch of other men tried to explain to me the difference between a baby daddy and a single father. Now, after I've heard so many times from men that there is not a difference between a low-energy baby mama and a high-end single mother, I flat out said to these dudes, you know, single father, baby daddy, whatever. Oh, they argued me down. No, single fathers are their fathers that actually take care of their children. And I'm like, honestly, how many black men out there are actually single fathers? On the post on Instagram, it said that single women should not date single fathers because the mothers of their children didn't think they were a catch. Or they still be with the dude. And then I thought to myself, like, wait a minute, that is not logical because sometimes people have a great person that they take for granted. So just because a woman or a man is no longer connected to the person that they had a child with doesn't mean either of them are bad. You can't guess who's bad in that situation. One person's trash is another person's treasure. Sometimes people learn lessons and they're better after the last relationship that they were in. Sometimes, I'm not saying all the time, but sometimes. And I decided, you know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna make a video for people who are actually good at co-parenting, right? Because there's people out there who are good co-parents. I'm a great co-parent. I don't do baby daddy and baby mama drama. I think I put enough miles between my son's father and I, so there will be no drama, you know? Don't nobody wanna be arguing over a 3-year-old, you feel what I'm saying? But I have a 21-year-old daughter and I had an amazing co-parenting experience with her father and we're still friends to this day. Like, as you get older, you start realizing that just because you're somebody's ex doesn't mean you gotta hate them. Before me and my daughter's father had our daughter, we decided that we was gonna love our daughter more than we hated each other. And that actually turned out great. You know, when you mature enough to agree to disagree and just be done with each other and just let it go and keep it moving, everything is smooth. Too many people be inside of their feelings and it harms their children. Too many people are using their children as like pawns to hurt their exes. Some mothers are even treating their sons like their son is their man. I was like, I ain't never gonna be that one to do that. I promise you that. I saw this story about Jim Jones talk about his mother taught him how to French kiss. I was confused. I was like, excuse me?
Did your mom tell you about sex when you were young?
She told me everything about sex.
Like, what?
My first condoms, shit like that. My mom taught me how to kiss. when I was younger.
What did she tell you to do?
She told me how to tongue kiss when I was younger.
Like, what's the instructions?
It wasn't no instructions. She showed me with her mouth. Like, she
kissed you?
It's my mother.
No, I'm just asking. Okay. I love it. My parents kissed me, barely kissed me on the cheek.
Like, I kissed my son on the cheek. I even kissed my son on the mouth. But ain't no way in the world I'm going to be touching tongues with my son. Eyo, he's going to have to learn how to French kiss from that puppy love chick he runs into in middle school. That's going to be the one to teach him how to kiss. It ain't going to be my mom. I'm sorry. Not me. But all of the men out there who are single, right? And you always hearing stories about single mothers being like the worst women to date. Of course you're going to hear that, because right now I think the trend of everybody's podcast and how they're out here making all of this money off of trashing black women and stuff like that. Yeah, I be peeping it. Now all of the men who feel like they didn't have a voice before, now they have a podcast where they want to complain about the women that they failed to attract or whatever. Everybody out here pointing fingers, but not a lot of people can provide solutions to the problems. So all the men out there who actually want to be stepfathers, let me give you some advice. One of the complaints that I hear men say all of the time about dating single mothers is that they cannot discipline their girlfriend or fiance's child. Now, here's how you do it. It's like the Da Vinci Code. I figured it out. Now, when you men say this, it's common sense. I get it. You are correct. Water is wet. Gatorade tastes like sweat. But it doesn't mean that you at some type of disadvantage. What you do as a man, as a stepfather, or as a person that happens to be a positive male role model in a child who has an absent father or who has a father who is abusive or whatever the case may be with that child's father, of course you cannot discipline that child. But what you can do as a man is support his mother when you are dealing with a child. You can always be that child's hero, that favorite person that child loves to be around. Okay, so every time his mother is disciplining him and he's upset, or she's crying because she got a spanking from her mama, or whatever's going on with this kid, what you do is you come in as the hero after that with the fun stuff, making them feel better. Y'all too good cop, bad cop. So when she out here disciplining her kid, she bad cop, remember? You come in as good cop. That's how you get favor with the kid. See, once you get in favor with those kids, your experience is even better than it was, because you already got a woman that you're dealing with that you're feeling. You know, y'all have a good connection. And you're sitting there and you're like, oh my God, I'm not a father. I don't have any kids, but she got kids. Instead of looking at the situation negatively, you come in the situation as good cop. Most good mothers have good disciplinary skills and their kids are actually well behaved. How a single mother's children behaves lets you know a lot about that woman. When she's disciplining her kids, or you feel like she's not disciplining her kids enough, say something to her. But at the same time, you don't know what kind of arrangement she has with the fathers of her children. Until you build a solid relationship with the child, you will never be able to discipline them. A mother will never feel comfortable with you disciplining a child until you build a solid relationship with that child where the child actually trusts you as an adult or trusts you as a parent. And that takes time. That's not going to be something that just happens overnight. It doesn't even happen overnight with children of your own. And I understand this is like a complaint for men. They're like, oh, I can't discipline our kids coming in that situation. You're right, you can't. But what you can say is your mother loves you. You know, your mother wants you to be better. You know, after she disciplined her kids, come in and have a conversation with the kids. Talk to the kids. You know, your mom loves you. She wants you to do this. She wants to be you to behave. Show that additional support. Be that backbone. That's all you gotta do. Not all children are bad, and not all children are hard to deal with. So when you're dealing with a high-end single mother, it's a very different experience than when you're dealing with a low-energy baby mama. Because most of the time, low-energy baby mamas don't know how to deal with their kids. They never took any parenting classes. They don't go and try to get some advice. They don't apply logic to their disciplinary skills. It's just difficult, you know? They just don't understand it. It doesn't mean that they're a bad person. They just don't know how. So I always encourage single mothers, take parenting classes, you know, read articles on how to be a parent, and whatever parenting style you have, whatever type of parent that you are, just try not to be an abusive one. And if you're And if you are a guy who is out here dating a single mother, please understand something. Not everybody is out here having a negative experience with a single mother, okay? I hope this helps.